الحمد لله رب العالمين، والصلاة والسلام على سيد المرسلين، والعاقبة للمتقين. أما بعد، number one, Islamic history. Hazrat Luqman alayhi salam, the wise. Approximately 3,000 years before Hazrat Isa alayhi salam, there lived a very pious man in Arabia called Hazrat Luqman alayhi salam. He was the nephew of Hazrat Ayyub alayhi salam, sister's son, and his origins are traced to the Nubians of Sudan. He arrived in Arabia as a slave and was a very pious, abstinent, wise, and intelligent man. And his words of wisdom have been preserved as Sahifa Luqman by the Arabs. His wise words are also quoted in the Quran in Surah Luqman. The Quran quotes the following words that were his parting advices to his son. O my beloved son, do not ascribe partners to Allah. Without doubt, shirk is the worst injustice. Surah Luqman, verse 13. He also said, O my beloved son, establish salah, instruct others to do so. Good forbid them from evil and patiently endure whatever difficulty afflicts you. Verily, this ability to bear difficulties with patience is from among the most resolute of matters, demanding the most courage and determination. Do not out of pride turn your face away from people, refusing to listen to them, and do not walk arrogantly on earth. Verily, Allah detests every arrogant boaster. Surah Luqman, verses 17 to 18. Number 2. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam's miracle. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam foretells of a time when prosperity will be widespread. Hazrat Adi radiyallahu anhu reports that Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam once said to him, if you live long enough, you will see that a man will bring a handful of gold and silver to spend in charity, but will not be able to find any poor person to give it to. Bukhari. Ulama write that Hazrat Adi radiyallahu anhu lived to the age of 120 years. And experienced the period when this really happened during the Khilafah of Hazrat Umar bin Abdul Aziz rahimahullah. Number 3. Afarad. True testimony. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said that giving false testimony is akin to committing shirk. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam repeated this 3 times. Abu Dawood. Note that just as it is fard obligatory to abstain from shirk, so too is it fard to abstain from false testimony. Number 4. A dua from the Quran and Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. The dua to be safeguarded against Jahannam. The following dua should be recited to be saved from Jahannam. ربنا ما خلقت هذا باطلا سبحانك فقنا عذاب النار. Translation: Our Rabb, you have not created all this without a purpose. These things certainly display your power and greatness and have not been created in vain. We glorify your purity. None can ever be equal to you. So save us from the punishment of the fire of Jahannam. Surah Ali Imran, verse 191. Number 5. An-Nafl. Preparing someone to go out in the path of Allah. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, that the person who prepares another to go out in the path of Allah will also get the reward of going out in the path of Allah. Muslim. Number 6. A sin. Lying to entertain people. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wasallam said, "Destruction be for the person who speaks lies merely to make people laugh. Destruction be for him. Destruction be for him." Abu Dawood. Number 7. This world. Halal earnings. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wasallam said, "Never think that your sustenance is far off, because a person will never die until he has not received his allotted sustenance. You should therefore choose the best manner of earning your sustenance. Earn halal sustenance and forsake haram." Mustadrak. Number 8. The Akhirah. The people of Jannah will see Allah. Looking at the full moon one night, Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wasallam said, "You will be able to see your Rabb in Jannah just as you can see the moon without any difficulty." Bukhari. Number 9. Cures from the Quran and Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wasallam. Salt. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wasallam said, "Salt is the best of gravies." Ibn Majah. This means that even if there is no gravy, salt can be eaten with bread. Allama Ibn Qayyim rahimahullah writes that salt improves the food as well as the body. He writes also that white salt is best and that salt cleans the teeth, removes dirt from them, and even strengthens the gums. Even today's dentists recommend salt to treat gum diseases. Tibbun Nabawi. Number 10. Advice from Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wasallam. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wasallam said, "The generous person is close to Allah, close to Jannah, close to the people, and far from Jahannam. On the other hand, the miserly person is far from Allah, far from Jannah, far from people, and close to Jahannam. The ignorant person who is generous is more beloved to Allah than the learned scholar who is miserly." Tirmizi. Subhana rabbika rabbil izzati amma yasifun wa salamun ala al-mursaleen walhamdulillahi rabbil alameen.